folks, welcome back. I'm back. I'm playing Worm Unlimited.
Eventually. Oh, hey, I probably shouldn't do that. You probably can't actually hear me if I put my hand up. Also, if your ears are bleeding or if you cannot hear the stream, let me know. I do not sound check this often enough, and sometimes the background noise from all of the fans and whatnots changes considerably, drastically even. So let me know if you have any problems hearing the stream, and I will be happy to modify it to your liking. Oh shit, I really need to drink water today. rats. Pardon me, people. I am not here. I am completely elsewhere mentally. Geez, what can I say about Worm? Worm is cool. I'm enjoying it. Right now what I need to get into is the steady, endless hum of the shovel and the pickaxe and the hatchet. Shovel, pickaxe, hatchet, anvil. Just endless, endless, endless. Just tinkering, making little iron bits, making little steel bits. Rivets, nails, ribbons, arrowheads, God knows. Butchering knife blades. God, I can't even. a chain. The various types of chain, obviously. Especially now since they'll be able to wear lead chain. Washed thoroughly. No, seriously, don't wear lead in chainmail. In addition to being particularly shitty armor and poisoning you, it's probably very heavy. So, I don't advise it. The region is reasonably safe, thanks mostly to the guerrillas of Point Discord Center. Discordia is based on Maul Rehan, and as a result, gets the automatic guerrilla spawn therefrom. They seem to chase away everything else, not that Point Discord was ever dangerous. It's actually been completely safe the whole time. Eek, that sound has got to be washing me out. I'm looking at that. That is my background noise, folks. It keeps my background in the background. Rather than the foreground. For some reason, the background's always trying to jump into the foreground. It's a big problem. You know what I mean.
kind of goofy, hilarious magic tricks.
Damn it. I bet Joel's going to get something. Somebody sent... Somebody looked down on Joel Hodgson. Is he alright? They can't... There's no way they weren't friends. There's no way they didn't at least know of each other. Jesus. I could be wrong. They could have been terrible rivals, but I just don't... I don't buy it. two really nice kind of 80s, 90s magician guys. You got to assume they were probably friends. Like showing up at the exact same events and stuff. Okay, whose year is it to win a Lifetime Achievement Award in TV Magic? Oh, I guess Joel probably never has. It's a shame. Anyway, enough rambling about 80s TV stars. I don't care that much. I'm not, like, that much of a fan. I kind of know stuff about people, but that's all. I would say I've been, like, a mild fan of a few artists, and that's actors. It really takes something special. You have to be amazing for me to even notice. Basically, if you're not Patrick Stewart or Derek Jacobi or something, like, give a damn. Jeez. Susan Sarandon's okay. God bless her, Angela Mitchell. Angelina Jolie's still gone. Oh yeah, everybody else in the world kind of moved on past it, but she's still goffing it up. It's not about the money, it's about something else. It's impressive. Speaking of Lifetime Achievement Awards, there's somebody who needs, let's all take a moment to remember that someday Angelina Jolie will be gone. Because like, you know, Harry Anderson was cool, but not that world-changing. He probably did more good in little chunks. That's the kind of guy I bet has been in more hospital pediatrics wards, making more kids laugh and smile over the years. So, probably would have looked that up, but I would bet. anyway, fun stuff. I don't know. I like talking about kind of fun stuff. Which is funny, because I'm like the villain. So... how hilarious is that, to have a storyline in which the bad guy is like this super emotionally sensitive person? I don't know, it kind of works. I don't know. Don't bother me. Most of all, folks, it doesn't bother me whether or not you watch or care. If you do watch or care, and you feel like leaving some sort of message or missive, just let me know what you think of the show, and by honest to God, at this point, I will probably do whatever it is you think is interesting, because I'm kind of bored. And it's not like I'm going to stop streaming, but, you know. If people don't show up, it really lessens the enjoyability of ranting and raving. So, what I'm going to do, left to my own devices, of course, no one will ever hear this, speak freely, build like a little goat farm or something, and just set up some wacky shit, and every time, a viewer comes on, I'm just going to run around and do wacky shit. And, like, burst balloons with a laser and throw water balloons at goats. It'll be fantastic, trust me. So much. lament about this world, my great complaint, the thing that really bothers me the most, is...
It's just that.
An unnecessarily cruel place. And I know it's been said before, believe me, I know I'm not inventing any new philosophies by suggesting that the world could be a nicer place. It could be. People could be nicer to each other. We could resolve disputes in ways that resolve them, rather than this endless cycle of warfare. I'll tell you, folks, I'll tell you right now, North Korea and South Korea set aside their differences. They end that war. I'll take another look at peace. I'll give it another thought. That would be cool. I would be quite content and quite satisfied if one of the greatest, longest-lasting wars on the planet Earth were to end. If that could happen, then maybe all wars could end. I could take another look at the idea of being peaceful. So, please, do that. if anyone on the planet Earth gives one crap about my opinion vis-a-vis Korean unification, I say do it. I say do it, and then let's be at peace with both Koreas, and I'll be okay with that. There are other ways I can bring about what I want to bring about. It would be more happy for me, more of a relief for me, if the world were at peace when I end it. That's a joke. No, really. Let's say the world were going to get hit by a giant asteroid. And I'm not saying it is, and I'm not saying it isn't. I'm not a astronomer, so I don't know whether or not the world's going to be hit by a giant asteroid. Not specifically. I certainly have feelings about giant asteroids, but I don't choose to share those. I might write, like, a poem about a giant asteroid or something. What do you guys think about stalkers? How do you feel about stalkers? Do you feel that people should be allowed to stalk other people or other people? How many miles do you have to follow someone before it's your time? At what point are you in love with the person you're following around? I am sorry. Whoever you are has been following me around. Seriously, so. And I've got all sorts of pictures of all of them. And I'll just be getting more. So please, follow me around on my next vacation. Please. Get real close. That shit's funny. Like, how dumb do I have to be not to notice the same face in them? What is wrong with you people? You really don't have lives. At the end of your life, are you seriously going to have your memories be of me? Fuck. What's wrong with you? I'm sorry. No one watches this, so it's not a big deal. But, wow. Holy crap, man. At what point does your desperation, do you realize what's happening? You know. Anyway, it's not my problem. You can't make it my problem, no matter how hard you try. It would be illegal for you to make it my problem. So as long as the rule of law exists, you won't be able to do what you're trying to do. The police will prevent you. Isn't that weird? It's weird. I think it's cool. I actually gain respect for the police every day that goes on. It's very strange. It's probably an age thing. I know it's associated with age. I guess I'm starting to wake up and see the world a little differently, and it just doesn't look like the police are as bad of the bad guys as I used to think they were. I know things still go wrong, and if I can figure out anything, obviously I will do everything within my human power to end the tragic and ugly parts of it. But I think the big change for me came, and I've mentioned this before, so you may hear this story from time to time, but if somebody can find the episode of Cops I'm talking about, dude, check it out. It's an eye-opening experience. there's this episode of Cops, and, you know, I used to watch Cops in sort of a, like, man, damn the man. Look at them. They're putting their boot down. Like, fuck, man. Leave that guy alone. You know, he's just raving, rambling on the top of a building, drinking, you know, dirt. But then you see this one episode, where it's a meth head, and he's wearing literally nothing but soiled underwear. And he looks like a fucking zombie. You actually look like a real, like, State of Decay 2, like, holy shit, shoot it in the head immediately. You guys get that free plug there? I like State of Decay. The game, not necessarily the implications in monsters. Anyway. Yeah, full-on zombie, and he bites one of the cops. And he doesn't just, like, idly just, like, numb, have some hep. Just not just a little hep bite. But, like, grips onto the dude's arm and bites in as hard as he possibly can. And the one cop is, like, he's, like, doing his job. He's, like, sir, you must detach yourself. But he's also, like, he's, like, sir, get off of me. And he's, like, get this guy off. He's, like, yelling at his partner. And his partner simply begins to wail on the dude. And it was not a... It was not anger. It was not an act of violence. It was a medical procedure. It was the get this meth zombie off of me procedure. And it was no more violent to look on than a surgeon removing a gangrenous limb is violent. He was trying to remove the drug-addicted, presumably bacteriologically ripe meth demon off of his partner. And he was doing so just with methodical, regular baton blows to the base of the spine. Just like, there's your kidney. Just have a kidney. Just, you are a living creature, you have kidneys, and I can kill you. And I don't normally, it's not good to take joy from watching a human being beat another human being. Much less for me. I would not normally enjoy watching a police officer beat anyone. That's a terrible, terrible thing to ever have to have happen. Much less repeated blows with the nightstick. But in much the same way that shooting a zombie or a Nazi in a video game doesn't trigger that same sort of visceral sense of compassion that it would even if you're shooting, say, digital representations of kittens. The fact that it was a meth zombie and that he was acting in defense of his partner made him sort of like a paladin getting to swing as many hits as he wanted against the ghoul. Anyway, from that moment on, my entire viewpoint of police officers changed because I could finally see a situation in which maximum beatdown was the correct amount, was the proper use of force. And so, that was funny. If you happen to see that episode, just watch it in admiration for the clinical detachment of the two officers. Like, get off of me! Sir, you must remove your teeth from my I hope that if I am ever a... I hope if I am ever entrusted with deadly force, that I have the same amount of restraint in dealing with another human being. Because, you know, the thing that makes them both heroes is the fact that they've got a meth zombie biting one of them with presumably really disgusting infected teeth. And then they don't just throw his brains out on the street. Oh, that's and I'm telling you, it changed my world to think at that moment, like, wow. Those are the people out there on the street. I would have been a mess. I am not 100% sure that I have ever had enough training in any of any sort to be like, okay. And after the fact, the guy was not happy, but he was more composed than I could imagine anyone being after having removed the human's gnarly rotting teeth from their arm and then having to explain to the EMP that they now need every shot in the world. Oy. Anyway, sorry about that. I love that story. That one completely remade my view of the world. Like, once, there was a time. police violence of that level would have been just hard to believe that it could ever be necessary. But that was before the Nazi battle drugs got popular on the streets. So. But yeah. And that's my heartwarming story of America. I haven't seen anything like that lately. All I see is renewal and regrowth. I've been looking around. It's a bittersweet feeling because I am less necessary. Every time I see a shell being inhabited, it's like, well, I'm glad somebody's getting to have a good time there. And I'm glad the country's coming back. It's just, I would imagine myself as being, you know, the one person who wanted to do that. But it's good that there are more than just me, because I certainly wouldn't get to it. I'm too busy playing video games all day long. And dealing with, alas, other people, the great impediment to all progress. Oh, you gave a halt. Alright, I gotta see if I can maybe get up to 6 cylinders, and then I'm gonna have to do other work for a while. pardon me if it doesn't make for the most scintillating of wordplay. Got myself slaughtered. My gosh. folks, well, that's about an hour. I'm going to have to pop out for just a second, and I will be back probably in no more than another hour. I will be back in an hour.